It is set for one fall for the 15-minute time limit. Introducing first, Paul E. Dangeroulsy presents from Houston, Texas, weighing 321 pounds, Mean Mark.
Definite disadvantage in size anyway, and in power, the advantage definitely is the big Mark, and he's got to watch that heart punch, Jim.
He certainly does. Mean Mark, 6'9", 320. Flyin Brian weighed in at 226. And the youngster from Syracuse has got to use his speed and quickness. There's a good illustration of that. A drop kick. Mean Mark down to one knee, but did not go off his feet. Flyin Brian slamming the head of Mean Mark into the top turnbuckle, but really to little effect, if any.
Boy, when you're that big and you're that strong and powerful, it takes a lot to put you down.
Flyin Brian, that big foot kicking right off the apron. He fell throat first right over the steel railing. And Mean Mark now going out after Flyin Brian, the former Cincinnati Bengal, the hometown kid from Cincinnati, Ohio, had two dreams. One was to play for the Bengals, the other was to wrestle in the NWA. He's achieved both, but can he survive Mean Mark in this contest?
Well, he's been a professional wrestler for 2 years now.
That's a great move, great agility. He baited that side slam. Trying to get Mean Mark over, but he can't get him down. My goodness, the big man at 6'9" would not go off his feet. I've seen Flyin Brian use that move, Bob, to pin a lot of them.
Yeah, that's right, and he can take almost anybody off their feet. But at 6'9", 321 pounds, Mark was able to do it and take him back to the corner.
Mean Mark, scheduled, as we speak, to take on Lex Luger at the Great American Bash. Lateral press, two out of that situation. We want to say hello to the great fans in Baltimore and let you know that tickets for the Great American Bash going to be with us live. We certainly hope you will. I understand from promoter Gary Jester, tickets are on sale at all ticket center locations throughout the Baltimore and Washington area. Well, look at that haircut, man. Look at those fins. He's got every bald spot on his head covered up. Jay Tapper did a marvelous job with Paul E's hair.
Either that or he did some implants. I'm not sure which.
Haven't seen fins like that since a 57 Chevy.
Well, this is one place right now that Brian does not want to be. Once the big man gets you in his grasp, Jim, there's no escaping you.
The thing about Pillman, his greatest attribute in this matchup is being able to hit and run, keep the big man off balance. But Brian cannot let Mean Mark control the tempo and deliver high-impact moves like that one.
Jim, I tell you, you can tell just what kind of man Mean Mark is when you know a little bit about him.
One, two, Bob, and a half. The big man was very surprised he didn't get the three count out of that one.
Yeah, boy, he'd already started down that referee with that hand. I tell you, when you know a little bit about him, this guy's favorite pet is a snake, and Jim, his favorite hobby is hunting. He likes to kill things.
He's talking about Mean Mark, of course, and Pillman with those Ric Flair-like chops trying to fight back. Boy, he's one of the most courageous individuals that I've ever been around. Has overcome a great deal of personal adversity, but I'm not so sure he can overcome Mean Mark. The size differential, Bob, is about, oh, I'd say about 96 pounds.
That's right. Very close to 100 pounds, Jim. Not only that, but you're talking about 9 inches in height. And there comes a point where the size differential is just too much to overcome. And that may be the case for Flying Brian now.
But we have seen him against all odds, so to speak, and come out victorious. Don't count this kid from Cincinnati out. Meanwhile, puts a big elbow there. And Flying Brian adeptly moved out of the way and chops the big man and chops him again. But the big oak will not fall.
Well, that may have been the mistake that Brian was looking for.
The native of Houston, Texas, Mean Mark Callis. Most valuable player in the Lone Star Conference. That's a 6'9 power forward. Hey, the Hawks need some help. They got a new coach. And they want to sign this big guy up to patrol the middle.
That would have put him out for a day had he landed with that one.
Paulie Dangeroulsy, very animated at ringside. This nationally televised broadcast. Thank you for allowing us to come into your home, ladies and gentlemen, or wherever you may be watching this. We appreciate it very much. As Flyin' Brian fights back, and Mean Mark has yet to go off his feet. Over the top of Pillman. He stayed the count. What a move. And now Flyin' Brian's up top. Flyin' Brian purse. A drop kick. And yes, that took the big guy off his feet. A drop kick.
Mean
Mark. Pillman came right out of the corner. Mean Mark back on the attack. Man, he is resilient. Pillman up top. High cross body. But Mean Mark caught him. He caught him and drove him right across that top ring cable. His throat right across the top ring cable. The leg grapevine. And the big monster from Houston has won it.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's your winner.
And look at this, Bob.
He went
with a hard punch, but then he made an adjustment.
That's right, and what a gallant effort on the part of the youngster Flying Brian, but he just couldn't overcome the tremendous size and the tremendous power of the big man. There's your winner, Mean Mark.
Fans, when we come back, the United States Tag Team Championship will be...